Okay, welcome back. Now, is audio and video is clear or not? Please check. There was a technical issue, not only to our batch, so all the batches, the classes were passed. Okay? Perfect. Okay, good. Divya, you got the doubt that is classes going on or not? The class is running, my dear, but I have passed the session because not only for our batch, all the batches, every studio is a problem. Okay? Okay. Now let us continue. Let me share the desktop once again. So Rashmi, just wait. I will explain about special column. First, let me complete these two topics. That is what how you can generate globally unique identifiers for a particular column. Global unique identifier. Okay? For that, let me create a table. Create table. Okay? EMP info sum table. Afterwards I'll delete. Okay? Employee ID, EMPI, sorry, int. Okay? Int, some primary key. Now, ename, var char of 20. Now, there is a column, third column. Third column, what I want is, this is the code, SSN number, that means the social security number, whatever this column value is there, this column value should be in such a way, throughout the row, this number should be unique for every employee. So, it should be declared as unique identifier is the new data type. Which should be given, but automatic generation will not happen. Unique identifier, you should write default in the bracket to generate the, in the entire globe, no two records should get this value same. If you have employed in not one, no two members, no other member in this world should have the value as 101. That is uniqueness throughout the globe, not only for a particular table like that. So this is a unique identifier which should be auto-generated, means default. How to generate this global identifier? There is a predefined method, new sequential ID, empty brackets, open, close, fish. So when you declare that three columns, third column is unique identifier, so this column value is globally a new value. Note where it will be regenerated, same value is regenerated. It's a, that is a very lengthy number it will be. And that number automatically to be generated means a default constraint to be applied. And default constraint, what is default means what? If I'm providing the value for this column, generally it will take null. Now it will not take null. I will not provide value for SSN. I'll only provide value for EMPID and ename. And I will not provide, but still it will not take null. It will generate a new globally unique identifier value and stores in this unique identifier data type column, SSN. Okay, now let me execute this. I'm creating, there is one bracket missing, one more bracket, okay? So don't get confused, one bracket is missing. Now the table got created with a column, the unique identifier type column, whose values is automatically generated. Now I'll tell, insert into EMP info values, for which columns you are providing EMP ID and ename values, and one, Sneha, execute, okay, and add one more record, employee ID 2, Rashmi, select it and press F5. So one more record got added. Why it is taking time, you know, because it is creating one globally unique identifier value and assigning for the last column. Now you see what are the values are there. Select star from EMP info, select and press F5. What are these? These values are auto generated because you have given as default. And these values are created by new sequential ID predefined method. which creates global unique value, unique identification value. That value can be placed only in the columns which whose data type is unique identifier. Anywhere, whatever you want to treat, you take it on Anupriya. I mean that social security number, you take it as student serial number. Your wish. Okay, I mean that social security number, but if you want to take it like that, you take it. In employees, student, student serial number will be there. That is not SSN, it can ABC UG column name. SSN is not column name. It's a data type should be unique identifier and default construct to be applied and to generate automatically unique identity, globally unique value, you should use a method called as new sequential ID. Okay. This is about unique global unique values and very important. Please put your concentration file stream. I'm talking and everybody's concentration should be here and that should be completed in 5 to 10 minutes. Not more than that I'm going to take for this. I want to create a table. Just let me write here so that you'll understand. Create table, patient. The table name is patient. In that page, PID means patient ID in primary key. P name is patient name, where care of 20, and I even want to store the photo of the patient. Photo is a column name, and the data type of this should be given as where care or where binary, sorry, not where care. Say what JPG files, PNG files, photos, right? Where binary in the bracket max one data type is there. But what is this where binary max column? Are you going to store things so that in D drive, there are 5 patients in my hospital, their details I want to write in this, all the 5 patients' photos, as a scanned copy, means you can send JPG files are there with me, patient1.jpg, patient2.jpg, that's my D drive. In my D drive or D drive, my images are there. Now, what is my requirement is, patient's details to be entered into this. Patient ID 1, name is some XYZ, and here is the place. Do you want to write the content of patient1.jpg file and put in this list? No. What I will do, you know, I'll just place one reference which connects you to your, the file always will be in your D drive. But to connect to that drive patient1.jpg link reference I'm giving here. This where binary will not hold the image. It will hold the root of the file. Where that root of the file means you understood? So this is it possible, madam? Here you don't want to place the image. Image is already there in my normal file system, which is in D drive. I have a file as patient1.jpg. I don't, in olden days, what they used to do, you know, that file content, they used to read binary data and dump it into this. But they don't want to, then the size of the table becomes too heavy. So now they thought of not doing like that. Instead of dumping that image file into this, only make a link. File might be here in D drive. For my SQL Server table, I'll just make a link to this path. That is possible with where binary, but that is possible. Only giving the link is possible with the help of the file stream. With what? File stream. So, but for this type of work, if you want to do, it is not automatic, my dears. This type of tables you want to create with the support file system is the first and foremost. In your computer, SQL Server installed, in your SQL Server file stream option to be enabled. In your computer, you have installed one SQL Server in the computer, for that server, file stream option will be by default in the off state. It's your duty to enable it. I enabled, so it will work. But where should I enable, madam, miss? Now I am hiding my video for 1 minute. Just see, Windows key you press. SQL means don't go for management studio. You will get one configuration manager. Can you see second one? SQL Server Configuration Manager, this one you should take. None of the databases you can create to support file streams until and unless you enable it for your SQL Server. So when you go for SQL Server Configuration Manager, it will open. It takes a few seconds. Just wait. It's okay. This is SQL Server Configuration Manager window which you got it. And under the SQL Server Services, right side you see, what, this is my server. This is my server, my dears. This is Babasai is my server name. So right click on that for which you want to enable the file stream. So go to the properties, right click on that and go to properties. Then a window, separate window will come. Just wait for that. Just wait. You got it? And in this so many tabs you have, always high availability like that, but here you find that file stream. In this file stream, just wait, I just click it, it will change this. Just wait. Now have you seen, I actually all these three are not selected previously. Now it's your duty, first you come here and first you need to tick mark here, then it will be highlighted, so then tick mark here, then tick mark here. All the three to be enabled, then only you need to click on OK. When you click on OK, then file stream is enabled so that databases that supports the file streams can be created. Keep in your brain. In your SQL Server, you want to create a database that should support the file stream concept where tables can be created from the where binary columns. I want to make a connect or link between the where binary column and the original file which is in your operating system place, that is D drive, V drive, somewhere. Just link, instead of dumping the file will be in your new technology file system only, and in D drive or E drive only its reference will be placed as a link into your where binary column. That is possible. That type of tables if you want to create, the database that in which tables will be created in the database, for the database file stream while creating the database file stream to be enabled. To enable for that, first in your SQL Server it should be enabled. First work we have done now. Now you have done this one, means not sufficient, my dears. Now what you have to do, you are supposed to create a new database using so. Okay. You want to create a new database, okay, that supports the file stream concept. So if you want to do like that, until and unless you don't create the database with this feature, you cannot create any table that support that you can utilize file stream concept, that you remember. So create a database, okay, my NIIT, okay, on primary, this everybody knows, name is equal to my NIIT, file name is equal to D drive, my NIIT.mdf, this everybody knows. Now here you should put a comma, here you should write file group word, any file group name, my file stream group, any group name you give it. Here you need to write contains the file stream is the keyword. From this contains is the keyword. File stream is the keyword. Again, as usual, how you wrote name and file name, you need to write here. But any name without extension. Name is equal to any name, my dear. What will you give? My NIIT underscore data, any name. And file name is equal to, in single quote, D colon backslash. My NIIT underscore data. Don't give the extension here. That's it. This is the way how you can create a table that supports the file streams in your database without writing this file group, some file group name, contains file stream command like this. A database gets created, but that doesn't support the file stream concept. So when you give like this, Only path we will give Balmukund. Correct. I will show you that's what. Now I am creating a database, my NIIT, that should support the file stream. See, have you seen? Created. Now use my NIIT. In this one, you need to create a table. Table, which table? Right? This table only. Which is having var binary. Okay. You do like this. Create a table which has a var binary max column. And now how to insert the data in such a way that this photo column should make a reference to your files in your D drive like that. Let us see any images are there in our D drive. I feel there are four images. img1.png, img2.png, img. Let me check my address. IMG. Yes, yes, we have see 1, 2, 4, 5. There are 4 pictures are there. You want to refer to these are PNG files only. As per my knowledge, they are PNG files. These PNG files you want to refer 1-1 file for 1-1 record. So how you can do that work means let me, I have kept one file insertion time just to give syntax only. Just for syntax I am showing, otherwise it's a spatial data I already told. This is the important one. Here, when I'm inserting a record into patient's table, patient ID, and this also you will give. Here, cast command to convert into var binder. That's it. Nothing else. It will not put the image into this column, but it will make a reference from your column to your file which is in D drive img1.jpg. So that is the simplest way you have to do, nothing else. So you are not dumping your data into that. Let me go to SQL one. I think this is the one. Let me, oh yes. So I am inserting, you say insert into patient values 1 comma xxx is the name of the patient. Here I need to use a cast command, bracket close, cast command in single quotes, your root img1.png file as var binary in the bracket max. That's it. Finished. This is the way how you can refer to the files. There is a same always, one bracket I'll miss. See here? Now don't expect that your file has been dumped into this column. No, it is just making a link from your column to your data. I mean a new file system, new technology file system. That is nothing but NTFS. NTFS file system is what? New technology file system like D drive, E drive, somewhere your file will be there. That reference I will put it in my column instead of dumping that entire image into the column. So that my record also becomes lightweighted. If the entire content of this file you are dumping into the column, then it becomes a too heavy weighted record. What is the use of max? Where I wrote max, my dear? Maximum size, that means I'm not fixing the size of the binary file. How much size the binary file will be, nobody don't know, no, my dear. Max is the keyword represents any size of the var binary I can read and make a reference to that file. If I give in the place of this some number, only that much size files only we are having permission to refer. Var binary max is a data type like varchar, eraser, float, like that. It is also a data type that helps us to make a reference from your column to an external file which is in the where it will be think that which is in the D drive or E drive, somewhere your file is there, to refer to that from your database table column, make a link, we will declare that column as var binary of max. Is that clear now? Cast command is what? Whenever you are giving the file name, file name is like a string it will print, but that file name is not a normal file name. It is the address, the root of the file. to which a link to be created means it should be converted into the data type var char of max. Then it will become as a link. Max, that's what I'm telling Shubham. Max is not mandatory to be given. Max should be given if you want to refer to any type of file of any size. There is no size restriction if you give it as max. Instead of that, if you give any number, only that much high, that means that var char of 20. That means what, 20, maximum 20 characters only you can do it. But I want to refer to a binary file, that is JPG file or PNG files like that. Their size I don't know. Actually, the size will be so much. So whatever might be the size, I want to allow to refer to such type of files. Then var char of, var binary of max I should give. Cast is convert your root into link format. Cast is to convert your file root as a link format to connect to. That means I'm not dumping the file here. The file root I'm getting into this to convert your root into address, that means reference, to connect to your file. It should be converted into var binary of max. Ma'am, instead of image, please put some. Why not? Who said only you can place Excel file? Do you know? Simran is asking only image files. No. There is not only a JPG PNG. Excel file I can refer. I can refer .doc files. I can refer WMV files, MP4 files. Any type of file you are able to refer. Any unstructured files you can refer. If we are dumping the size of the file, the table becomes too much heavy, my dear. Please understand, Akshay. If you are dumping one record, only photo column will have 10 MB, 20 MB size like that. Then you understand. One record is occupying 10 MB or 20 MB means, if 10 records are there, 100 MB size, the table it is yours. Then when you try to read the data from that file, it becomes very slow. So always make your tables lightweighted. Understood? Make your table lightweighted. So if you want any file, don't take the file, only get that address. Whenever you want, go there and get the file. But don't dump that one into your home. Okay? In place of, can we mention the fact? I told Priyanka the same, max is not fixed. You can also tell the size, okay, in bytes. But that is, as a developer, it's not acceptable. Max only should be given because any size of a file you want to refer. I don't want to restrict to a particular size. Okay. So that's about file streams. So we have finished with insert. We will go for delete and update. Not more than 5 minutes I'll take. So 5 minutes for delete and 5 minutes for. Now let us go back to our previous database. That is what? TGJSDB1. This is a new database, right? Because our records are mainly in this. So I went back to ours here. Delete statement, DML statement, to delete selected records from a table, okay, keeping structure alive. Structure, nothing will happen to structure, only records will be deleted. All the records or few records depends on you. Now, what is, now I'm giving to delete all the records from a table, we have two commands, not one, two commands are there. We have two commands, my dears, to delete. One is, okay, delete, okay, from table name. That's it, don't write anything. Delete from table name is what, emp personal one. All records will be deleted. not one record, if 1000 crore records, deleted. And another method is what, there is one more command called as truncate. Truncate command, how you should give, my dear? Truncate table name. This is so delete command is there to delete all the records as well as truncate command. Then what is the difference between delete and truncate? The question also will get, you will get it. All records will be deleted, structure is allowed in both the cases. But using delete, if I don't want to delete all records, only few records I want to delete. Is it possible with delete and truncate? Yes, it is not possible with the truncate. Truncate is always used to delete all the records from a table. I cannot tell with the truncate, only that record you delete, this record you delete, like that. We cannot restrict. It always used for deleting all the records from your table, but structure is alive. But no, few records, but not all records. Then, to delete only condition matched records, but not all. Then same delete command only. How you can delete from table name where some condition? Do you know, my dear, what will happen? It will check the whatever table you said, it will go to the table, and for every record it will check the condition. Wherever condition satisfied, that record gets deleted. Condition satisfied means record deletes. Condition not satisfied means it will not be deleted, because your goal is to delete, but the records which satisfy this condition. Okay? So, a simple example. Now I'm going to show you the examples. I'm not showing you delete from table name, because it deletes all the records. So, let me show you the records from EMP personal 1. Otherwise, extra EMP personal 1 is there. Why don't we delete? Because they are waste tables anyway. So this Mahesh record, whose employed is 3, I want to delete. Only if employed is 3. So I am giving delete from XEMP personal 1 where EMP ID is equal to 3. If I don't give, what will happen, madam? What will happen, all of you, right? I did not tell about drop command. How do you tell that I did not tell about drop command? One of you are writing that I did not tell about drop. In the last class, I did not tell. I said very clearly, if you use a drop, it deletes the structure of the table, including all the records. I told very clearly. Then how do you say that I did not teach it? I do remember what I taught. All records will be deleted from the table. 100% correct, all records will be. Do you want to check like that? Anyway, it's a waste table. So I'm doing like this, FI. So total, how many records are there in that? All the records deleted. Here it is 2 records. So it's telling you, see, 2 records are deleted, it is saying. Just see. Select, why should I write? Anyway, this command is the select statement. Run it now, 0 records. Just wait. Now 0 records are there. All records got deleted. Now there is one more table, ex-employee. Okay, ex-EMP personal. See the records. In this one you remove, so that in that you have 2 records. Based on employee ID I want to delete. Only employee ID 3 I want to delete. So how should I write, my dear? Delete from ex-employee personal where EMP ID is equal to 3. Finish. It will delete only one record now. Now you press F5. It deletes only one record. Now you check what is there in the EMP personal. Only one record is left. Other record got deleted. Which one you are asking to repeat, Govind? Entire column delete will not be there, my dear Divya. First, delete is not to delete the column. Please understand, it is not to delete the column. It is to delete the record. Records deletion, not columns deletion at all. Drop command, why are you... That's what I'm telling. It's a mandatory that you people should read after going home. If you don't read like this, you'll ask me again and again, what is drop command, which creates a problem to me, right? Drop command, I did not tell you in the last class, Govind. What drop will do? Not only records deletion. I told very clearly, taking the papers, I told, like taking the papers. This is my book. So drop means what? No, this is a table, means tearing. Tearing in the sense that here table is there, records are there. Records I'm not erasing. If I'm erasing, record structure will be there, only records gets erased. That is a delete or truncate. But drop will not only structure and records, along with structure, all the records gets deleted. That means indirectly, it's like I'm tearing. When I'm tearing, what happens? Table structure also lost. All the records of that also are lost. That is drop. Last class I told, again you made me to repeat. Please, every day, 4 hours your class you don't think. 10 hours you think. 4 hours you learn from me. 4 hours, 2 hours or 3 hours you go learn from the course where 3 hours you practice. PGP is not like I'll just come and I'll go and enjoy, means not possible. Okay? Your services are like that, very fast track. How do you expect these many topics will be completed, these many modules in the 3 or 4 months? Just understand? It's because of fast track course. Everybody should think that you should work for 10 hours per day. You, not only you, I am working for 10 hours only for your batch. Then why can't you do? So, okay, next. Deletion done. Next work is what? No, update. Update means what? So let me show you the record select start from EMP personal. In the EMP personal, we check, not EMP personal, EMP personal one. In this one, how many records do you have? 4 records. By mistake, this is mail I wrote. Okay, otherwise, Neha, I wrote null, but I want female. This null to be replaced with female. Why this Govind record still available? Okay. So, I want to replace this read. Am I adding new record? No. Am I deleting record? No. What am I doing? A particular gender column value, old value, I am replacing with a new value. And marital status, yes. That means S means what? Single. I want to update these two columns. Whose employed is 4? Whose employed is 4? I want to search for the record whose employed is 4. And I want to update that records, gender and marital status. Even in update, if you don't give the where statement, it not only updates this record 4, all the records, gender and marital status gets modified. Are you understanding? If here also, when you are using update statement, if in case if you don't provide the where statement, it indicates that you are asking in every record gender and marital status to be updated. But I don't want like that. So how you can give update statement means to update the data, to update a column value of the selected row or rows. Okay? So we'll use update, but what is the syntax, my dears? Update, table name, no table keyword, table name directly, update after table name. SET set. Set what column? Column name is equal to new value. What is the new value you want to set for that column? One more column I want to set, madam. Column name is equal to new value. But for which records? These two columns are telling which records these two columns. So write where condition. Where some condition. So this condition for which records it is satisfied, only for those records these are columns values are updated to the new value. In our case, what am I doing? You have the update, okay? EMP personal one set, SET set keyword. What is the first column? The gender column I want to update to female, comma, and another one is what? Marital status I want to update to yes, okay? But for all records now, where EMP ID is equal to 4. So whose employed is 4? Only for that record you set and update the gender and marital status columns to F and S. So now I pressed F5. Now done or not, you check, all of you. See here, F5, you got it or not? This is the way how you can do it. Is it clear all the statements or do you have any doubts? Please let me know. A lot is there to learn. Please let me know. Any doubts? I will help. Insert, delete, update is finished. But there is something working with the output data is there, which takes of 3 to 4 minutes. That also I will tell. Then there is a merge statement after the break and XML, working with XML data. After the break, we have to finish. Then fifth chapter will be finished. Rashmi, no doubt. Very good, good. Govind. Govind, clear. What happened, Govind? Oh, clear. Good. So now there is a word. Now I will just show you once, okay? Before, when I am doing some insert statement or delete statement or update statement without knowing to your knowledge, there are some magic tables, what are called as magic tables, are created with fixed names. What are those, you know? Inserted is one table, deleted one table. There are two magic tables will be there. Those two gets created without your knowledge. Internally, they are helping us. Why they are created means when you are trying to insert a record, this is a table into which you are trying to insert a record with insert statement. How it will happen, you know, when you are inserting, a magic table named as inserted will be created. Your data first go to magic table, then only it will be inserted into your table. But how long this inserted magic table? It's a magic table, temporary table. Correct, 100%. These are temporary table. How long it will be there? Till the execution completes, inserting into your original table, success. Till the time it is, once it is success, this temporary table is lost. You will not get back, okay? And at the same time, there are some my records in my table. I'm writing the delete statement to delete second record. Okay. When you're writing delete statement to delete, directly it will not be deleted. First, what happens, you know, there is a magic table named as deleted will be created. This record you are deleting, that record will be saved into that deleted magic table. Then it gets deleted from your original table. Okay. And once the deletion operation from the table is over, again this magic table will be deleted. Inserted, deleted. So when you are going for insert operation, the new record never directly will be saved into your table. First, it creates a magic table named as inserted, whose structure same as your table structure, and your record will go there. Then that record again will be saved into your table. Now once it is successfully saved into your table, now this magic table inserted, removed. That means it gets deleted. It's a magic table. It gets, meanwhile execution part of time it gets created. Once execution is success, then it will be deleted. Success or failure also it will be deleted. Yes, recycle bin. But recycle bin, you can restore back. This is a temporary table, gets created and deleted automatically. When you delete any record from a table, really it will not be deleted directly from your table first. Instead, it creates a magic table deleted. This whatever record you are thinking of delete, that record it will store it in deleted magic table. Then it deletes from the original table. First one it will not delete. It puts that record into magic table deleted, then it will delete. Once this is successfully deleted, now this is magic table also is gets deleted. So their lifetime of magic tables is, they get created once you start insert or delete or update operation, and they gets deleted once the operation is successfully done. Then what about update operation, madam? Will I get updated magic table? There is no updated magic table. Then what magic table? When you do update statement, both gets created, inserted as well as deleted. Why is the question? Indirectly, when you are updating your previous Neha record only, Neha record previously, what is the old record before updation? For Neha, Neha at 1a.com, mal, and some mobile number. This is the record you are deleting and updating with a new value, that is for Neha, Neha at y.com, female, single and mobile number. So what the computer will think, you know, when you are updating, old record is getting deleted, with latest updates new record is going to be added, like that it will think. So it will say both the magic tables inserted as well as deleted, with what is the existing record before updation. Before updation, what is the existing record, that it will put it in the deleted magic table. After updation, how it looks like, that is a new one, that will be in the inserted magic table. Yes, Ma Aditya, my dear, to tell that one only this much history I told only for that, okay? So, now how these magic tables I can utilize when you are in really magic tables are creating like that if you want to check. Let me show you first records. You can see these records, am I right? This is EMP personal one, okay? In this one, let me try to insert one record. Generally, do you remember? Insert or delete or update when you are doing, those records it will not show at the bottom. Simply to write one row affected, two rows affected, zero rows affected, like that it will tell, but it never show which record got affected. Which record you deleted, it will not show, one row affected. What record you inserted, it will not show, one row affected, like that number only it will show. No, not only number, which record recently I added, that record to be displayed on the screen also. Then magic tables help I'll take. Now you say insert into, generally what you'll write, my dear? Insert into table name is what? EMP personal 1, okay? Values 5, J1, okay? J@nit.com, male, single, so I have given like this. And see here, at this point, I want to tell you, this is my insert statement. When you exit 100%, you will get only as one row inserted. But it will not tell which record got inserted. You need to give again select statement, select star from your EMP personal one, then only you can get confirmation it got inserted or not. But now I'm telling before to the values, before, okay? Before to the values, you just give a command, output is the predefined keyword. The output of this, output means what, which is recently inserted record, where it will be stored first, in a magic table inserted, inserted dot star. There is a magic table got created as an output, and from that all the columns with all the rows, please display. So let me execute three outputs. Previously only one row affected like that, now you see. What happens if we check? You see, actually is it saying that one row affected? What it is telling? Record got inserted, record inserted record which is in magic table, first it got saved in the magic table inserted, that got displayed. That is, that's output to be displayed externally. That is what, now you see, your table is having that record, this is directly how it has shown. So I don't require to see in this also. EMP personal 1. See here whether my record is there or not, you check it, my dear. Yes, it's there. So not only like this I want to check at the time of insertion that record which recently I inserted, only that record to be displayed. That recently inserted record first it will be saved where in your inserted magic table. So with out keyword if you write, it also gets displayed on the screen as an output. That the result of that inserted dot star also will be displayed. Now I want to delete a record, okay? Ramesh record whose employee ID 2. That record I want to delete. Deletion time, which record got deleted also I want to see. So delete, generally what you'll write, delete from EMP personal 1, okay, where EMP ID is equal to 4 you'll get, right? But now before to the where statement, okay, you write output command. Here what magic table will be created, my dears? Deleted. So which record you are deleting? That record to be, that record is in deleted magic table, please display on the screen. So it will be deleted, no two doubts. But the deleted record, instead of simply saying one row affected, I want to display that record which got deleted. So now I am giving this. No, no, sorry, it is not 4, it is 2. Okay? Now I am pressing F5. Now this is which record? 1 minute. If there is nothing wrong, let me execute. See here, this record got deleted now. This is the real output which was saved in your deleted dot star. And now you check the records from this EMP personal, it got deleted. But I have seen which record got deleted also very easily on the screen. Now update. Update what I'll do for Mahesh. Okay. This mobile number I'll change. This is all 9s I'll write. Okay. Mobile number I'll make it as all 9s. So why I'm doing update. Okay. Update. What is the methodology? Do you remember? Update. EMP personal 1 set mobile is equal to. What is the new value? My dear? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Single quote. Okay, where EMP ID is equal to, where EMP ID is equal to 3. This is, but before to this where statement, okay, you have two magic tables. You want to display the modified record or deleted record, you decide. So, if I'm writing output, see the difference. Output. And I'm saying the deleted dot star means it will display the old record which is really available in your table. In your table, what record is there? Mahesh record with 940s, 940s. This record, deleting record is this, modified record is with latest value 49. That if you want to see, in place of deleted dot star, you should give, let me hide my video because it is covering. See here, output means here output, you will get both the magic tables got created here, both deleted as well as inserted. But if you say output of deleted command, then what really, so this is why I wrote there, I'll write at the bottom. So if I do like this, you just understand, deleted means old record which is already existing. And in case of the place, inserted if I give latest record with modified value of mobile, you will get it. So now old, that means, just to see, it gets modified, but what gets displayed is old record. See here, deleted record is this, but really updated or not, if you want to check, execute your select statement, so that you can see that. It is, see here, it is modified or not? You can see here, modified. No, no, modification time, all 8s I will do now. Same work I am doing now, all 8s I will do. I'll make it as all 8s for the same record. And I'll make it as here inserted. So if I give inserted, old record which is 9th I will not get, latest modified, with the modified record how it is that you are going to get it. See here, modified record, plus in your table also it got modified. So this is about output statement. That means not only simply giving the message as one row affected, two rows affected, which rows affected, that rows also to be displayed means yes, with the help of magic tables, inserted and deleted, and with a keyword output which can display on the screen. Inserted table contains after updation, deleted table contains before updation, that means existing one. Yes, yes, Bal, 100% you are right. Recover the deleted rows from magic. We can recover the magic tables, but you will get it in triggers time. More and more you will work with magic tables in triggers. That time you 100% you will work with magic tables only. Okay, that time you'll understand, Simran, don't worry now. Just for knowledge of inserted, that after going to triggers chapter, never I'll explain about magic tables because I have already explained about magic tables, right? Now, there is one more topic, so many topics are left over. One is magic statement. What is the magic statement? When you should use the magic statement, that I have to tell, and working with XML data. So many options are there. So I have already prepared, from there I will tell. It does not mean that I am just now I prepared and same, right? So you can understand. Those are very important. It takes a time, so that much actually XML data this much I need, right? If I'm writing in front of you, it will take time, so I have written first. So that I will go through after the break. Break of how much time? 15 minutes exactly. If you take more, you take it, but I will continue exactly by 3:45. Okay? Exactly 15 minutes, 3:45 short the session starts. So break for 15 minutes. 15 minutes break. 15 minutes break.